In this tutorial, we'll look at some common questions in the topic of atomic structure. The first part of atomic structure, we learn about the particles that make up the atom or the subatomic particles. The important thing to remember would be what is the relative mass and charge of each subatomic particle, or namely your proton, electrons and neutrons. So in this question, what is happening is that a beam of your subatomic particles are being passed through a pair of charged plates. So in order to solve this question, you need to know a very important concept in nature, which is that opposite charges attract and like charges repel. So how would the particles behave on passing through the charge plates would depend on this particular concept. So it's important to be able to recall that electrons, being negatively charged, would therefore be attracted to the positive plate, and protons, being positively charged, will be attracted to the negative plate. How about neutrons? Neutrons being neutral, it carries no charge, so it will not be affected by the charge plates. It will just go straight. The direction will not change. So this question is very kind, because there's only one option that matches what we have just described. So the answer is A. Now, in some higher order questions, you may encounter an option that looks like this. Say, for example, I will change option B to the following: electron, neutron and proton. So in this case, if I were to change option B to the following, you will find that it matches whatever that we have just said. Okay, so on comparing options A and B, which option would be correct? In this case, option A will be correct, and option B is actually wrong. Now, why is that so? If we compare options A and B, the only difference would be the angles of deflection. You'll find that in A, the electrons are deflected to a larger angle than your protons, whereas in B, your electrons and protons are deflected to the same angles. Okay, so why would electrons be deflected to a larger angle? Is due to the relative masses of an electron and proton. If you can recall, electrons are very, very, very much lighter or less massive than a proton. So when subject to the same attraction or same force, the lighter particle is going to move away at a larger angle. It's going to be deflected by a larger angle. Okay, so something that we learn in A levels is that the angle of deflection is actually inversely related or proportional to the mass of the particle. The next very, very common question in atomic structure is to find the number of protons, electrons, neutrons given the nuclide notation of an atom of that element. Okay, so this is something that we have also learned in lower sec, so I'm not going to harp too much on it. But when you are looking at such questions, one important thing to take note is to look out for ions. Okay, look out for ions. What are ions? Ions are charged particles that are formed when atoms lose or gain electrons. So over here, if you look at the two particles here, I hope you can spot that oxygen, in this case, is an ion. Okay, and based on the fact that an ion is formed when an atom loses or gains electrons, now the number of electrons and number of protons in an ion is not going to be the same. Okay, so let's do the example of potassium first. That one should be pretty simple. Number of electrons is 19, which is the same as number of protons, and the number of neutrons would be 41 minus 19, that would be 22. Okay, for the oxide ion. Now this is slightly tricky. Number of neutrons, we can still take your nucleon number minus your atomic number, so that would give us 9. But the number of electrons, if you are not careful enough, you put it as 8 because the atomic number or proton number is 8, but it's not 8 because it carries a charge of 2 minus, meaning it has taken in 2 additional electrons. So the number of electrons is actually 8 plus 2, which is 10. This question is very similar as the one before. We are supposed to find the number of protons, neutrons, and electrons. And once again, you need to be very, very careful of the ions in the list of particles. Okay, and once again, when we look at ions, the number of protons and electrons are not going to be the same. Okay, essentially this question is there because I want to go through the concept of isotopes, but let us complete the table first before we go on to a discussion of isotopes. So very quickly again, the number of electrons in chlorine would be 17. The second particle is actually chlorine 37. For potassium, the number of neutrons would be 39 minus 19, so 20. The number of the protons in bromine should be 79 minus 44, which is 35. And then the number of neutrons in bromine 81 would be 81 minus 35, and that would give me 46. And lastly, the particle with proton number 37, for that you need to refer to the periodic table, is actually that of rubidium, which has the atomic symbol Rb, and the nucleon number would be that of 48 plus 37, so that would be 85. Okay, so for the nucleon number of rubidium, please do not simply look at the periodic table, because whatever number that's given in the periodic table is not the nucleon number but the relative atomic mass. Okay, so how do we get the nucleon number is to just add number of protons plus the number of neutrons. Okay, next we are asked for the definition of isotopes. It's very important to remember that isotopes have are atoms of the same element with same number of protons but different number of neutrons. Now this is one of the rare definitions that you'll be tested on, because for O-level questions, it's very rare to have definition questions. So the common definition questions that we'll get will be isotopes, macromolecules, and what's the last one? Weak acid or strong acids. Okay, so these are the few remaining definitions that are still being tested these days. Next, we are supposed to identify two atoms which are isotopes. So we need to look for the same number of protons but different number of neutrons. So the two particles would be chlorine 35 and chlorine 37. The next question is related to the concept of isotopes, but more of the calculation of your relative molecular mass of a molecule that's made up of atoms that have different isotopes. So for example, over here we are looking at the molecule of water, which is made up of oxygen atoms and hydrogen atoms. Hydrogen atoms can exist as two different isotopes, hydrogen 1 and hydrogen 2. So in this case, the question is asking you to find out what are the possible values of the relative molecular masses of water. The very first thing you need to be able to do is to write down the formula of water, which I believe all of y'all would be able to do, H2O. And from there, you need to next recall how to obtain the value of relative molecular mass essentially is the sum of the atomic masses of all the atoms in the molecule. So the molecule is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom. And since hydrogen atoms can exist as two different isotopes, we can have different combinations of atoms. We can have hydrogen 1 combining with hydrogen 1 with oxygen 16. We can also have hydrogen 2 combining with hydrogen 2 with oxygen 16. Or we can have hydrogen 1 combining with hydrogen 2 and oxygen 16. So these are the three different permutations of atoms that we can get. We can combine to get water. So once again, the relative molecular mass would be as follows. It would be 18, 20, and 19. So all three values, 18, 19, and 20, are possible values of the relative molecular mass of water that is made up of hydrogen 1 and hydrogen 2. The last question is on electronic structure or electronic configuration. Essentially, it means the arrangement of electrons in electron shells within an atom. The important thing to remember here is that in the periodic table, the group number tells you the number of valence or outermost electrons, and the period number tells you the number of occupied shells. So to solve this question, you can essentially go to the periodic table and look up for the element. Again, then you write out the electronic configuration, or you can simply notice this, that if it's in period 3, so there will be 3 occupied shells. Okay, and if it's in group 15 or group 5, Roman numeral 5 in the O periodic table, it means that it would have 5 valence or outermost electrons. So the electronic configuration for the element would therefore be 2.8.5. Okay, because the innermost shell can only have 2 electrons, subsequent shells can have up to 8 electrons.